Rome is an ancient city with monuments dating back 600 years before Christ was born. Everywhere you go, there are monuments glorifying Rome's ancient history. Legend says Rome began around 2800 years ago by Romulus and Remus, two boys who were brought up by a wolf, as shown in this famous sculpture at the Capitoline Museum. Around 2500 years ago, Rome may have looked like this scale model, which is located at the Museum of Roman Civilization and is based on archaeological evidence discovered over the past several decades. Unlike today, you can clearly see the seven hills upon which Rome was built. By 300 AD, Rome had a population of over a million, as shown in this large-scale model. It's interesting that 25 years later, Emperor Constantine, the first Christian emperor, moved the capital to Byzantium in Turkey and renamed it Constantinople, known today as Istanbul. The reason Constantine moved to Byzantium was to integrate Rome's more prosperous eastern provinces into the Roman Empire, and he probably wanted to get away from all the corruption and decadence that Rome had descended into by that time. Another interesting model is the Roman Colosseum, which was built by Emperor Vespasian and completed by his sons during the last quarter of the first century. It's estimated it had seating for 87,000 spectators. This is the Colosseum as it looked in the city around 300 AD. What remains of the Colosseum is still spectacular. In fact, it has recently been voted one of the new seven wonders of the world. This is where naval sea battles were recreated by flooding this entire central area. At other times, there were gladiatorial battles featuring both human and animal combatants. Emperor Trajan once staged a contest between 11,000 animals and 10,000 gladiators, which lasted 123 days. The Circus Maximus is thought to have been initially constructed by the first Roman kings 600 years before Christ was born. It is the largest public structure ever constructed by the Romans, which eventually had seating for 250,000. Today, it is used as a public park. In 2005, to celebrate Italy winning the Soccer World Cup, over 700,000 fans packed the stadium. Overlooking Circus Maximus is the palace of Emperor Domitian. This is how the palace looked when it was completed at the end of the first century. It was then used by every emperor for the next 300 years. Even today, the remains give one a feeling of the enormous size of this complex. This is the Roman Forum during the height of the Roman Empire, which for centuries was the center of Roman public life. At the north end is the Capitoline Hill, where the Romans built their most important temple, the Temple of Jupiter. Today, the hill is home to Rome's City Hall and the Capitoline Museum. However, even what remains of the Forum is something to behold. At the bottom of the Capitoline Hill is the Mamertine Church, under which are the remains of the Mamertine Prison. This is where St. Peter and Paul were held prisoner before Nero had St. Peter crucified and St. Paul beheaded. Legend says St. Peter was crucified upside down since he did not want to offend Christ. Also, according to legend, St. Peter caused a well to spring up from this opening so he could baptize his fellow prisoners. St. Paul was executed at St. Paul's Three Fountains Church. It is said that when severed from the body, the head bounced and struck the earth in three different places from which fountains sprang up. Near the entrance of the Forum is one of the most impressive monuments, the remains of Constantine's Basilica. Construction was initiated by Maxentius at the beginning of the 3rd century and finished by Emperor Constantine after he defeated Maxentius in the Battle of the Milvian Bridge, which crosses the Tiber just north of Rome. These remains have influenced the leading architects of the Renaissance. This painting and computer reproduction show the marvel of Roman engineering and artistry. Even Penn Station in New York City replicated its main features. Also very impressive are the remains of the Mausoleum of Hadrian, known today as Castle San Angelo. This structure was constructed by Emperor Hadrian between 135 and 139 AD as a mausoleum for himself and his family. It was later used by the papacy as a fortress due to a strategic location adjacent to the Tiber River. The statue at the top depicts the angel for whom the building derives its name. In addition to building the mausoleum, Hadrian rebuilt the Pantheon, which is the most important example of pure Roman architecture still in existence. It was originally constructed by Agrippa, top general to Emperor Augustus, 25 years before Christ. This is how it looked during the time of Constantine. Romans loved to bathe. First of the great public baths were the baths of Emperor Trajan, constructed at the beginning of the 2nd century above the Roman Colosseum. They dwarfed the earlier baths of Titus, as indicated in the top left-hand corner of this model. Trajan's complex covered 17 acres. Here, you can see its relative size compared to the Colosseum. Today, the area is a park, and very little remains of these baths. 100 years later, Emperor Caracalla constructed the next great public baths. These baths were enormous, with bathing facilities for 1,600 people covering 33 acres. These are the remains of this complex as it looks today. There were 308-foot frescoed vaults covering the large pool rooms. It had a variety of hot and cold pools, huge gym, two libraries, one for Greek and the other for Latin, and a whole wing of shops, all finished in brilliant mosaics. Another 100 years later, Emperor Diocletian built the largest baths ever constructed. His baths could hold up to 3,000 bathers at one time and cover 32 acres. What remains of the baths today are near the central train station. Rome is truly an amazing city. It seems that everywhere you go, there is a monument of interest, such as the Round Temple, more commonly known as the Temple of Hercules. This is the oldest surviving temple in Rome, made out of marble. Just look at this detailed work. Or the Temple of Portunus, which was constructed in the 1st century before Christ and built as a temple to the god of the Tiber River. What a city, and what an incredible collection of ancient monuments. If you are interested to travel to Rome or any other international travel, you should contact Elaine at these numbers. She is a professional travel advisor, specializing in custom travel adventures to Italy, Southern Europe, and in South and East African safaris. You will not be disappointed.
Fettuccine e vino dei castelli, come ai tempi belli, che Pinelli immortalò.